So my name is Alan Leggitt. I'm a second year PhD student in the neuroscience program at UCSF. And I'm in Adam Gazzaley's lab, which studies cognitive neuroscience, which is basically the neuroscience of how people behave and think and remember. And my particular interest is in emotional distraction. So if you were trying to remember somebody's like phone number or something, and while you're saying to yourself the phone number, you know, you witness a car accident or something, there's no way you're going to remember that phone number. But you know, what is it about that car accident itself that takes over your ability to remember that number? Versus if you were to just witness, I don't know, a car just passing, you know. I joined the Army out of high school, served in the infantry for 5 years, and deployed to Iraq for 13 months. I think seeing a lot of the things that soldiers struggled with when they came back from Iraq, like post-traumatic stress or traumatic brain injury, or even you know, people who've lost lost limbs, or they've lost sensitivity in their skin because of burns. These were all things that I saw affecting my fellow soldiers, and I thought that getting into science might help them. You know, there might be I could find a way to use neuroscience to help treat post-traumatic stress, or to help treat traumatic brain injury, or to help develop more advanced prosthetics or something. So I'm preparing for my qualifying exam, which is basically I have to present all my experiment ideas to a committee of scientists who are then going to approve me advancing to candidacy. So right now I'm doing a lot of reading papers and trying to plan the experiments that I'm going to do. And I also do a lot of development of code to analyze neuroimaging data. So I mostly use a programming language called Python. It's free to download and free to use. And there's a huge community of people who around the world who use it to develop anything from video games to analyzing neuroimaging data, or they do statistics. So it's really like a very broad programming language that people use worldwide. When I was first starting out, I got my bachelor's degree in physics. And what this is doing is you're saying that the change in Z, the state of various brain regions, changes with the state of all of the brain regions that are in your cell.
The only thing stopping me from going off and pursuing something like post-traumatic stress research was just this idea that I had to just sort of take whatever I could get, you know.
Z2 is going to be the dorsolateral prefrontal cortex.
Don't be afraid to not know what you want to do exactly. You know, like if you just kind of want, you know, you want to get into science, but you don't know if you like biology or chemistry or physics better. Like that's not a bad thing. You can go in not knowing what you want to do. And that's fine. I didn't know what I wanted to do when I graduated high school, which is why I joined the Army. But, another option would have been to go into college with an undeclared major. So you don't necessarily have to settle for something just because it comes along. Like, you can go out and do exactly what you want to do. I wish someone would have told me that.